Hey guys, me again with another YouTube video. Today we're going to be taking a look at another AK. Believe me, I know you guys are probably tired of seeing the AKs, but I wanted to test something out with Studio 2.0 by Bricklink, and that was kind of rendering using letter tiles, stickers, things like that. So I needed a test bed for that, and I of course chose an AK, as the AK is one of my favorite rifles out there. So a couple of changes right off the bat that you guys need to be aware of. There's not too much new going on here. This is all stuff that we've gone over before. I just kind of really want to direct your contact, your eyes to the lettering, but we'll get to that. So this uses that 3D printed handguard design from a futuristic AK. It's here. It's got rails on both sides. No big deal. This is the same angled foregrip that you guys have seen me use everywhere. This uses the Elysium upgraded optic sight thing here. The laser is still here. And then this uses the RPK SIC or RSPIKC 19 version of sight here. But that has the built-in 2x magnifier. That's up here. It has a transparent magazine. This is a 45-round magazine instead of a regular 30. And then the back rail here is also available. I don't know why I put a back rail here, but I kind of wanted more lettering, so I went ahead and did that. But like I said, this whole project here was just a ground for using stickered and lettered pieces in Studio 2.0 and taking a look at exactly what they look like. So on this side over here, you can say superconductor will overheat without air. I don't know where at a superconductor is on this entire thing, or like what's going on in terms of headcanon or anything like that. I just thought it sounded super cool as like a warning label to put on it. And then there is a laser up here, so I put the avoid direct eye exposure logo here to get that down. And then on this side, there's a button here that you can push to flip this magnifier up, and you can't really see it, but in like this GIF here, if we make this bigger, well, that didn't really make anything bigger, but you can see there's more writing here. It says push to magnify right here. So something that's interesting is, I don't know what happened, but I guess my version 2 of the purple sterling, which is what this is called, got deleted. This rail section back here had this little jut out right here. You can see it kind of in the GIF. There's a section that sticks out just past this rifle here. You can kind of start to see it over in this side. In the actual LDD version, it's just a rail system right here. I don't know exactly what happened, but it's not there for some reason. Like I said, I don't know exactly what happened. It's just, I may have deleted the one file that I needed for this. I'm not really sure. So I used this as a couple different tests. I did the lettering here in 4K, and then I also did this as a GIF. Obviously, for some reason, you know, GIFs inside of MacBook don't automatically play. So like I have to hold down and it basically acts like a slideshow. But this spins continuously since it's a GIF the entire way. So I also did that as a test bed to see if this computer was capable of handling that, and exactly how long it took. That took about like a day's worth of rendering, so like 24 hours to get just that one GIF. So clearly I do not do that quite often for good reason. That said, thank you guys so much for watching. Remember, comment, and subscribe for more videos similar to this one. I'll see you guys later in another YouTube video another time. If you guys have any direct questions that you want to ask me, or you want to see models come out before they go out anywhere else, don't be afraid to check out my Discord. If you need a link to join the Discord, go ahead and drop a comment down below, and I'll get back to you as soon as possible with a link for you to join. Thanks for watching. See you.